How's it going, everybody? I'm Drifty from Driftwood Gaming. In this RPG Maker Envy tutorial, we're going to continue our Chrono Engine tutorial super guide. In this episode, we're going to talk about how to replace some of the art. In this particular episode, we're going to look at the ATB gauge, and we're going to replace that ATB gauge as well as some icons on the side if we feel like you can find some better icon ones. So basically, really, it's just replacing one file, and I can show you how to do it in Photoshop or GIMP or whatever. You can make whatever file you want. You're going to put it into a specific directory. So we'll look at that file again. So basically, we're going to make this purple ATB thing. And we're going to set, basically its size and where it's drawn. We could put it on the left side, on the top, on the bottom, wherever we want, actually. Let's take a look at how you would do something like that. First thing we're going to do is go to Game and Open Folder. That's going to open up the your Games folder. Go into the IMG, and then you want to go to Chrono, and then ATB. So in here, you're going to see this file, and it's going to say ATB underscore gauge. I've renamed mine to underscore original, and then I've created a new one. So if we look at the properties of this file, we can see that it's actually 63 by 229. So when I was looking in the help file, or what do you call it, the parameter, plugin parameters, I saw that where it was calling that size. So when I made mine, I wanted mine bigger and I want it moved over to the side. So in Photoshop, basically just create a new, or GIMP or whatever, just make it like 64 by whatever. So 64 is the X, how wide it is, and then the second number is the height. So I went 64 by 500, which is, you know, maybe twice the size of the other one. And I think it looks worked out pretty well. So what I did was create three layers. One thing I did notice is the bottom, you want to leave some, like, background transparency. So you actually want most of this transparent, just like the bar has some opacity. So I've made this back row layer 85% a see-through, or 85% opacity, and the same for that. And then the top one, the little line in the middle, 100. All that doesn't really matter. Make your own art, right? But what I'm letting you know is at the bottom, leave a little bit of extra space, because it'll look like the way the plugin is set up, it brings them down to about right here and then puts them back up. So it brings them about right here. So if you have it drawn all the way down, they're going to come down to about right here, and you're going to see that they look like they go to the end of the turn, but they're, you know, they do, but the picture doesn't fully represent that. So I put a little bit of free space right there. But that's it. Export that as a PNG file, and you want to save it inside this folder. Rename the original so you can still have it, and then replace the original with your art, ATB underscore gauge. If you want to change the actors icons, all you have to do is change them right here. Keep the same name, but just change the art, you know. So rename this one to actor underscore one original, and then put in your own that you want. And we'll look at the properties on these. You want to use your own actor PNGs. The details on this, 37 by 37. Now you can use whatever you want. So 32 by 32 probably would work fine. 48 by 48 would probably look good. So it's up to you. You could even have little little arrow icons that would just scroll up and down with the face on it or something. But this works for now. Replace your art, and then let's move on. So you're going to need, obviously this is for the Chrono Engine, so you'll have these plugins if you've copy-pasted them into your new project, or you're using the project that Mog Hunter gives you from default. But basically we're going to be looking at, what is it called? Chrono Engine ATB heads-up display. So the plugin right below the Chrono Engine. So right here is the x-axis of where you want the heads-up display ATB bar to be shown. So you have to use this number depending on your resolution of your game. I'm using 1280 across by 720 down. So if I want it to be all the way on the right-hand side, I need to give it a high number close to that 1280, because we got 00 up in the top right, and then we got 1280 on the top right, so top left, top right. So if I want to be pretty close to the edge but not all the way, then I'll take away 100 pixels, so I say 1180. So it puts it 100 pixels from the edge right there. You could use whatever number you want. That's just to show you how to do it. So the same thing for the y-axis. So 00 is up here. But as we go to the bottom, like the bottom left, that would be 0, 720 for me. So if I want this to be drawn, like, where do I want the top left part of the picture to start being drawn? And I said 120, so it's going to go 120 pixels from the top, and then it's going to start drawing that bar from there on down. So that's how that works. Okay, this next parameter, enemy X offset, X-axis offset, basically it's going to draw the actor one or the enemy picture on the right or the left side, depending on, or in the middle of it, depending on where you want it to be drawn at. So remember, adding to X will push it to the right, subtracting from X will push it to the left. So we're having the enemies on the right-hand side of the bar and the actors on the left-hand side of the bar. And that's basically how it is. And then this is for when it's their turn, when that unit activates, where do you want their icon to be displayed? Well, we're going to subtract 3 from their current X, and then, or actually we're going to look at where it's at and then use -3 where it's being drawn. And then also from where it's at the top, we're going to use -30, which is actually going to subtract from the Y, which is going to push it up further. So it's going to take your icon, and when it gets to max and it's your turn and you're going, it'll put your icon in the center top, and then it'll bring it back to the side and start bringing it back up. And when it gets to the top, it goes to the center and activates. And that's what that does. So the gauge size, you're going to need to change this depending on the size of your Y value inside your file, the PNG file itself. So on this one, my ATB gauge, the one I created, I went 64 by 500, so my y-axis is 500, so I'm setting the gauge size to 500. So now it knows how big the file is, so it'll stretch out some so that the actor's head goes through the whole thing instead of just a section of the picture. We'll talk about how to add some more stuff, but you can see how they go to the center when it's your turn. So it's our turn, but we need to activate. You can see that our icon will get pushed to the top right, or boom, you know, in the center there. And this enemy will go top left, will go, and so forth and so on. So basically, all we did was we replaced one piece of art with another piece of art, and we moved it around because we changed our resolution, right? So that's it. We'll talk about moving all the other stuff later on, too, in another tutorial on how to move... all your, I think we already talked about moving some of the other things, but yeah. Such a cool plugin. I hope you guys check it out. That's going to do it for this quick tutorial on how to basically add new art for your ATB gauge and how to customize it, so forth and so on. Hopefully you guys like these tutorials. If you do, please subscribe to the channel if you're new here. Give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy it. Thank you so much to my Patreon supporters. You guys are awesome. Continue to stay awesome. If you would like to back me on Patreon, I'd love to have you. Links in the description below if you want to come hang out in the Discord and come chat with us and just hang out with a bunch of other people who make games and program stuff and make art and all kinds of cool people. Link to the Discord is in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.